Hello guys, my name is Raza Masood. Today we will discuss about the computers according to the sizes. Guys, hope this topic you will definitely enjoy. So let's start from supercomputer. What is basically a supercomputer? Supercomputer are basically are very large in sizes, and you can just see from here these are very large, and you need a particular AC to cool down these computers. These are very large computer, and they are very very complex computer. They use many advanced design techniques and have very high computing capacities and speeds. Supercomputer users are people who needs to process complex data. For example, automotive engineers who simulate cars crashing into walls. Like for example, any engineer who has to analyze the data of aeroplanes, and like how an aeroplane can fly in air, he needs to analyze the data. So these types of computer who needs very complex processing and very large, needs very great speed and capacity, so we use supercomputer. Next is basically the mainframe computers. Mainframe computers, from see you can hear, mainframe computers are large and expensive. They have powerful processors and very large memories. They are used in large banks, airlines and universities. We normally use these types of computer in banks, airlines, because there we need good processing speed, very large memories. So I'm sure whenever you go on airport or a railway station or any bank, you definitely see these types of computer. These computers reside in their data center, and by using these computers they use a centralized computer processing for their system. So these are very big and very great powerful and processing speed. So these are called mainframe computers. Okay, now the next is mini computers. Mini computers, you can see from here these pictures. These are basically small computers as compared to mainframe. They are smaller and cheaper in price than mainframe computer. They have less processing power. Mini computer can process large amount of data and used by medium or large size business, colleges, banks or libraries. These are not very much bigger, and they are cheaper, and they are used in colleges, for example, to store data of students. Also banks use these types of mini computers for their data transaction processing. So large size business organizations basically use these sorts of computers, but remember these are cheaper, and now they have been replaced in the market by the microcomputer. Now moving towards the microcomputer, these are microcomputer. See, microcomputer also called as desktop computer and personal computer as well. They are a small business, they are small and basically used by small businesses, schools and in homes. So normally in the day, these sorts of desktop computer used by personal user or single user, they are very cheaper and smaller, and they are used by a single user. And microcomputer has replaced the mini computers in the market. Now let's move towards the laptop computer. Laptops are basically from, see you can hear, these are very having very fantastic shape, very good. And laptop computer also called notebook computers and are smaller than desktop computers. They consist of a keyboard, monitor, processor and storage devices built into a single case. So laptop computers are very good. They are portable and you can move them easily any place. Smartphones and tablets, you can see, these are also called as computers, and they are used for instant communication, networking and many other utilities. Smartphone and tablet computer are based on a touch screen interface along with gesture control. You can see from here, these are the basically smartphones and tablet computer. Embedded computer are basically is a macro computer that is fitted into a device to control its operation. Microcomputer, also called embedded computer and tiny specialized microcomputer processor installed in smart appliances and automobiles. They are used in toys, cameras, microwaves and air conditioners. So see, you can see from here, these are embedded computer and normally used in AC. So thanks a lot for your time, and that's all from my side. Hope you like this video.